Hey everybody, welcome back to the next Blender tutorial. Today we will be making a farming patch. So let's get started and continue where we left off in the previous tutorial. We will start with adding a cylinder and set the vertices to 16 sides. At the moment the cylinder is still too big, so we will scale it down to 0.1. So first of all, we want to set the dimensions of this farming patch. I want it to be around 2 by 2 meters. So first select the cylinder, then we go to wireframe view and then go about 1 meter to the right. And we will go about 1 meter up. Because in the end, when we will mirror everything, it will be a farming patch of around 2 by 2 meters. Now with numpad 1, we get the front view and we will drag it along the z-axis a little bit up, so it's just barely under the ground. Now go back to solid view mode and go to edit mode. Now we will select face selection and then select the top face. With I we do an inset, scale it a bit down, and then with E we will extrude along the z-axis a little bit down. And then again we will inset, scale down a little bit, inset and scale down a little bit, and finally inset and scale down a little bit. Now with Alt and Shift Alt we can select the two rings and then hit E to extrude and then with Z along the Z axis. I found out that I made a little error and I made one inset too much, so I'm deleting the face, deleting one of the edges, and now that is fixed again, and then with F I remake a new face. Now go back to the object mode and then at the bottom we can add a new material. So add a new material. In this case I first named it Tree Outer, but I'm changing the name to Tree Dark because I think it suits it better, also in combination with the other ones. So the first one will be Tree Dark, the next one I will call Tree Medium, and then we will add one and call it Tree Light. Alright, go back to the Tree Dark and then go to Material Preview. Then you will see what color the log is assigned. So first we will make a dark brown, brownish color. Doesn't need to be perfect because we still will change it a little bit when we import it into Unreal. Okay, now go to the edit mode. Then select the first face in the middle and then with the numpad plus button you can increase the faces around it. Then on the right side you can copy the material from the tree dark and we will paste it in the tree medium. We will make it a bit lighter. Maybe change the values a little bit that it looks nicer. And now we still need to assign the material to these faces. So click assign. So copy again the material and paste it into the tree light material. So now I think it's easiest just to select the faces. We only want to have the light color. So select those and then also with Alt you can select the whole ring and then assign them to the light color. Alright, looks good. Now go back to object mode and with the right mouse button hit shade smooth. The shading on the top looks a little bit off, so go to object data properties, select normals and then hit the auto smooth. Now go back to the solid mode view. And we will add our first modifier, the mirror modifier. first set the origin to the 3D cursor and also mirror on the Y axis. Go to edit mode and with numpad 7 we can go for the top view. Select vertex mode and now go to wireframe view so we can select the whole log. With shift D we can duplicate. Now we only want to delete the left half side of the log. However, now we still have a hole in the top of our log. So select the two vertices and press F to make an edge. Then select all the edges and hit F again to make a face. Now go to the materials and assign the tree light to this face. We have to repeat this process for the bottom of the log since it also has a hole. So select the two vertices, make an edge. Then select all the edges and with F make a new face. And then assign the tree dark material to this face. Switch back to wireframe view and select the half log. Make sure in the mirror modifier that clipping is selected. Now move the log along the X axis until it hits the Y axis. While still in top view, zoom a bit out and select the whole log on the right. And hit Shift D to duplicate and duplicate the log 4 times in total. Use a bit of your time to evenly spread them out between each other, as long as there's still a bit of overlap. As a tip, I would recommend to select one vertex of a log and press Ctrl-L to select that log specific. Now select all of the logs except the last one on the right and press Ctrl-L so all vertices are selected. Zoom in on the last log, then select the 3D cursor tool and place the 3D cursor in the middle of the log. Zoom out again and set the transform pivot point to 3D cursor. Now when we rotate, it will rotate around the 3D cursor. Press Shift D to duplicate and press R to rotate and then type 90 for a 90 degrees rotation. Now we can go and check out our results in the material preview. All logs have the proper material, however I noticed that in my model the half logs don't properly align to each other. So to solve this, just go back to the top view mode in the wireframe and select the vertices. Now give them a final push along the axis so that they will align to each other. Make sure that clipping is turned on in the mirror modifier for this. Now go back to the material preview and we can see that we solved the problem. The logs now nicely align along the mirror edges. However, when looking at all these logs, I find them too perfect on the same height. So let's add some variety to it. First, select one vertex per log and then use Ctrl-L to select the whole log. Then move the logs a bit down on the Z axis. Also repeat this process for the other side of the corner. Now the outer edge is completed and we only have to add the earth in the middle. For this we will keep it nice and easy and just add a plane. First go to the mirror modifier settings and turn off clipping. Then with S scale the plane smaller. For a good view, switch to top view and wireframe view. Now before aligning the plane, turn on the clipping and then scale it up until you reach the center of the logs. Go back to the material preview and you can see that the plane is still too low. So bring it up along the Z axis so that it is almost at the top of the logs. Go to the materials and make a new material. We will call this farm earth and give it a dark brownish color. Also make sure to assign this to the new face. I will quickly check if all faces are oriented in the correct way. For this, go to Viewport Overlays and select the face orientation. As long as what you see is blue, then it is good. The bottom of the plane is red, that is correct since you won't see this side in the game. And finally, I will rename this object to Farm Town so that everything is organized. Now our farm tile is completed, and in the next tutorial we can start with making our first crop for the game. As a first crop, we will make 3 stages of growing wheat, harvested item and a seed that we can use to plant. Hope to see you in the next tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe for future tutorials.